الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن، وهو بكل شيء عليم. وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد، أيها الإخوة الأحباب، أيها الأخوات الكريمات، أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى عز وجل في هذه الأيام المباركات في شهر رمضان الكريم أن يبيض وجوهنا يوم تبيض وجوه ويوم تسود وجوه. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يدخلني وإياكم الجنة بغير حساب ولا سابقة عذاب. أسأله سبحانه وتعالى أن يتقبل منا الصيام والقيام والصدقات في رمضان يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين. Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, الله سبحانه وتعالى said in the Holy Quran, سورة الرعد verse number 11, the chapter of the thunder verse number 11, إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغيروا ما بأنفسهم. Look at this ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us a message here. And Ibn Sa'di said in his tafsir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always, He's the one He's giving us, He's a bestower, 24-7. We are living under His rahmah, mercy, bounties. He's giving us without any limit. With questioning or without questioning, He's giving us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can hold all of that when we change. From being obedient to disobedient. From being mu'min to kafir. When you deny the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will hold it. Because this is my ni'mah. He created all the heaven and the earth and He subjugated for us and He asked us just to worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's all, Azza wa Jal. Not just that. He did not give the choice to the heaven and the earth. He gave it to you. He gave you the choice. You can do whatever you want, but you will be accountable in the end. Dear brothers, subhanAllah, look at the end of, in the month of Ramadan. Really, when you Muslim Ummah, do you want to change? And I can call the month of Ramadan the month of the change. We have to change. We have to change from being bad to good, disobedient to obedient, from disbelief to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to change. That's why to change, you have to have intention for that. And sincere intention and suluk al-khalis. Practically, you have to promise Allah Azza wa Jal and you have to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala your goodness. Allah Almighty Azza wa Jal, He changed some of His sunan fil kawn in His universe for you because of the month of Ramadan. Didn't Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, when Ramadan comes, the gates of Jannah will be open? Allah changed it for you. Subhanallah, mostly it's closed. But Allah will open it for you in the month of Ramadan. And the gates of hell will be shut, will be closed. Yes, Allah will do it for you. He changed it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the shayateen, they are free all the year. But in Ramadan, He said, I'm going to change them for you. What do you think? See, He's changing everything. Not just that. In Laylatul Qadr, Jibreel is not coming to the earth anymore after the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Allah allowed him to come once. When? ليلة القدر تنزل الملائكة والروح هز الروح جبريل والروح فيها بإذن ربهم كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. فالله سبحانه وتعالى sending angels for you. He changing the وميس الكون for you in Ramadan. He made the change for you and He's looking at you. Are you gonna change? سبحان الله. You miss your salawat during the year. Now, are you gonna pray? SubhanAllah, you're being bad, are you gonna be good? Your tongue, your heart, your sight, your eyes, your, are you gonna change? That's why, SubhanAllah, Look at the man, it's an authentic hadith, the one who killed 100 people. What did Allah? Allah changed even the movement of the earth for him. He's a killer. He killed 100 people. Did you kill 100 people? Subhanallah. He killed 100 people. But we have somebody, they are killing not 100 people, they are killing more than that. Al-Mala'in al-Yahud. They are killing 60,000 or more from Palestine, from Gaza, Gazabin. They're shayateen. They are Zionist shayateen. Because this is not just against the religion, this is against the humanity even. If you look at this side, they are not human. Nobody can do that. These people, they have no mercy. And there is not, it's not something hidden. Subhanallah, subhanallah. In the social media everywhere. But anyway, that man, he tried to change, which is the killer of 100 people. When he killed the 99 people, he started talking to himself, man, am I going to stay forever like that? Kill people? I want to change. I want to make tawbah. And he started asking people, I want to make tawbah. They said, there is a monk in this area. Go ask him. Might be. We'll find a way for you. He went to that monk, abid, just abid, no knowledge. Is there any tawbah for me? I killed 99 people. He said, ya mal'oon, ya haqir, ya kelb, ya killer, ya kelb. He started criticizing him. He said, why are you thinking? I'm coming to seek help from you. This is the wrong sheikhs nowadays. We go to give them fatwa, fatwa, wrong fatwa, ala tool. It tell you fatwa, wrong fatwa. What happened to the man? He get his sword, he said, yalla, 99 is extra one, no problem. Oh, you're gonna make me crazy. And he get his sword and he shaved his head. Some scholars, when they explain this hadith, they said he deserved it. And I agree. Because he gives wrong fatwa. You're not supposed to give wrong fatwa to the people. Too many sheikhs, they need somebody like this guy. Allah Azim. For money, for position, for, they give wrong fatwas. To please someone, to make him happy. Against your deen, ya kharban? Against your deen? Huh? Just to give wrong fatwa? You are misguiding people? You're giving them wrong fatwa? This like this guy. He shift his head, he finished him. Huh? He finished him. Handle it now. Subhanallah. And that man, later, want to change? I want to make tawbah. I want to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Somebody guides him to a scholar, alim. He lives in this area and he was traveling. He was serious to make tawbah. He was very serious. He went to the alim. I did kill 100 people. Do you think Allah will forgive me if I make tawbah? I ask you for forgiveness. He said, who can stop you from tawbah, man? You're still alive. I said, alhamdulillah. But I advise you, you have to change your environment. These people you live with them, don't stay with them anymore. They will not help you to make tawbah. There is village so and so, go travel to these people, stay, they are salihin, they are good. Stay with them, they will help you. While he was going in his way, he died. Angel of death takes him, takes his soul. He died, and the malaika of mercy, they came to take his roh. And the malaika of punishment, they came at the same time. They started debating, dispute. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who gives his decision. Allah changed the nomis for this man. Said, measure the distance between the two villages. And subhanAllah, some of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shaped the earth a little bit and he just was close to that village he was gone. And he went to Jannah. He went to Jannah. See, Allah Azza wa Jalla changed everything for you. But he asked you just to worship him. That's why we are in the month of Ramadan. We have to fix our hearts. Any kind of envy, jealous, hatred, whatever. Subhanallah, shahna, al-baghda, all of that. Al-tahajur, all of this. We have to stop this in the month of Ramadan. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Sawmu shahru sabri, the month of patience. Ramadan. Wa thalathatu ayyam min kulli shahr, 13, 14, 15th every month, Hijra calendar. Qal yudhibna wahra sabri. You didn't eh? Wahar al-sadri. Allah cleansing your chest, your heart from any kind of bad things. When you fast Ramadan, you fast this 3 days every month. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. What about our tongues? Yes, backbiting, false statements, laghu, vain talks, la'an, criticizing, batil, kadib, lying, namima, slandering, all of that, subhan, backbiting. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, alayhi salatu wa sallam, من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة في أن يدع طعامي وشرابي. حديث رواه الإمام البخاري. If you're not stop lying, saying false statement, and misguiding people, Allah سبحانه وتعالى He doesn't need your thirst and your hunger. سبحانه when you fast, Allah doesn't need that. سبحان الله. And جابر بن عبد الله الأنصاري صحابي, he said إذا صمت فليصم سمعك وبصرك ولسانك عن الكذب وعن المحارم ودع أذى الجار وليكن عليك وقار وسكينة ولا تجعل يوم فطرك ويوم صومك سواء. That's one of the Sahabi is giving us good advice. I want you to fast. فليصم سمعك. You're here. Don't listen to any bad things. If people still in Ramadan, instead of listening to the Quran, they are listening to the songs. خلاص يا أخي, it's just 30 days. Songs again. What are they about? Imagine you die while you are listening to this. Subhanallah. And he said, don't look to the haram also. The Sahabi said that. Don't make the day you are fasting equal to the day before Ramadan and after Ramadan. They're not equal. And you have to have sakina and waqar, respect, because you are fasting in the month of Ramadan. You know, that's why very important, jama'ah. And be away from haram. Don't harm your neighbor. He said that, subhanAllah. And even if somebody is fighting with you during the month of Ramadan, tell him in the sabak ahad, inni sa'im, inni sa'im, inni sa'im. Sometimes people makes you mad. Tell him, I'm fasting, I'm fasting, I'm fasting. طيب, what can we learn from Ramadan? This is practically, this is what we have to learn. Alhamdulillah, we are fasting. Alhamdulillah, we are feeding. Alhamdulillah, we are giving charity. But Ramadan is a school. School you are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to us to train ourselves to be good Muslim, to recharge your battery, to your with iman and faith. First of all, what can we learn from Ramadan? When we see the Muslim ummah like you, mashallah, they are coming together in the masajid. Also, you with your family and your kinship, and subhanallah, you go to them with love, and you come to the masjid with love. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَتَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالْتَقْوَى وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. Help each other to make birr and taqwa. Subhanallah, but don't help each other to make animosity and ithm and haram. Also, in Ramadan, we learn the taqwa. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. تَقْوَى الله. More than 213 times Allah mentioned the word taqwa in the Holy Quran with different meaning, different definition. But Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib, he gives us very good ta'rif definition for the word of taqwa. He said, التقوى هي الخوف من الجليل والعمل بالتنزيل والقناعة بالقليل والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل. Ali ibn Abi Talib said that's beautiful ta'rif for taqwa. Said, الخوف من الجليل, to be one of those who are God-fearing. والعمل بالتنزيل, to follow the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. والقناعة بالقليل, to be satisfied and content with what Allah gave to you. I'm not calling you to just stay home, not doing work or not, do more, but inside your heart be satisfied. Because some people, if they give them billions, they will never be satisfied until they die and the eyes will be full of dirt. They will never say Alhamdulillah. Even if you have or you don't have, say Alhamdulillah, brothers. This is the point. Be satisfied, content. Alhamdulillah, Ya Rab. Whatever you give to me, I accept it. And it is not the quantity, it is the quality of what you have. People, they make 30, 50 a month or more, but there is no barakah. In the end, it's empty hand. Somebody making less, but full of barakah and blessings. He eat it, he got it, children, the family, in general, barakah. Look at the barakah, the quality of what you have, not the quantity of what you have. Also, one of the meanings is taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالِاسْتَعْدَادُ لِيَوْمِ الرَّحِيمِ. And this is what we are doing, all of us in Ramadan. We are trying with these good deeds in Ramadan, fasting, qiyam, Quran, sadaqat, all of that, to prepare ourselves for the day when we departure. Departure way. Yes, remember that. You're going to have one ticket, one way. Ticket for one way. SubhanAllah, not round trip, just one way. You're going to go to your grave, you're never going to come back. That's why he said, prepare yourself for that. يوم الرحيم, استعداد, be ready. Anytime. But if I ask myself and yourself, if the angel of death is coming to any one of us tonight, Are you gonna change? Are you gonna do something extra? If you say are you gonna do something extra, means you're bad. I'm sorry, because you did not do your job. But if you already said I will never gonna do any extra thing, Alhamdulillah, I'm doing good. I'm in very good healthy shape with the angel of death. I'm ready anytime. When you say I'm ready anytime, means you're doing your duties. You're doing your job with Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. Very important. Also, the Quran al-Kareem. The month of the Quran, شهر رمضان الذي نزل فيه القرآن. الله سبحانه وتعالى said, فجاءتكم موعظة من ربكم وشفاء لما في الصدور. Quran is an admonition, موعظة, and شفاء. Cure your ills, your doubt, your كفر, your disbelief, your hypocrisy from your heart. The Quran is curing you spiritually and physically كمان. Physically كمان. القرآن الكريم. Why physically? لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. فالله sent this Quran into a mountain. The mountain will collapse and crack. This is a mountain. What about you? You are flesh and you are blood. فالقرآن can cure your illness by the permission of Allah. Look to Ramadan to the فقراء, to the مساكين, and especially those who are outside Palestine, Gaza, wherever around the world, any Muslim being oppressed and weak and they cannot live and he's under the pressure of others, these people look for them. Help them around the world. Yes, brothers. Also, الفقراء والمساكين. Also, in Ramadan, we learn how to stand for قيام الليل, التراويح and التهجد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كانوا, when you talk about the مؤمنين, كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون. وبالأسحار هم يستغفرون وفي أموالهم حق للسائل والمحروم. Dear brothers, dear sisters, yes, we learn how to stand at night and to make your qiyam. You stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, brothers and sisters, be Allah. I love your brothers and sisters in Islam. والمؤمنون والمؤمنات بعضهم أولياء بعض. Love Muslims. Have loyalty to Muslims. To Islam, to your deen, to your brothers, to your sisters. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. We learn in Ramadan how to be generous. Rasulullah was super generous all the year, especially in the month of Ramadan. كالريح المرسلة. When you see very strong wind pushing and driving big clouds, and that clouds full of water and sending rain. Without subhanahu abundant. Allah Rasulullah was like that. Learn how to be generous like the Rasul and the Sahaba and the Anbiya like Sayyidina Ibrahim and others. Also, we learn in Ramadan sabr, patience. Some of us who don't have sabr. If somebody just push the button of you, oh, fire, khalas. You can make, you can divorce, you can kill, you can do everything. Easy, take it easy, Azizi. Calm down, calm down. Why? Because Allah said, it's sabr, the month of Ramadan. إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرْهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. May Allah make us amongst them, Ya Rabbi. Those who are sovereign, they will be rewarded, fully rewarded without any accountability. We learn in Ramadan how to be very close friend to the masjid. You're coming to the masjid more, mashallah. You're sitting in the masjid more. You're making zikr and the ibadah. And you're attending halakat al-ilm. And you remember Allah more. فَذْكُرُونِي Allah said, أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُونِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ How to remember Allah? Through your ibadat. When you come, you attend the salawat, tarawih, you read the Quran, you make zikr. All of this, fadhkuruni. And to washkuruni, be grateful to Allah's ni'mah. Wala takfurun. Do not deny Allah's ni'mah. Be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, الشعور بلذة الطاعة. When you feel that, while you're standing behind the imam in salat al-tarawih, every night, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لله في كل ليلة من رمضان عتقاء من النار. Every night in Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is freeing too many of us from the hellfire. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى يجعلنا وإياكم منه في هذه الليلة إن شاء الله. آمين يا رب. اللهم أعتق رقابنا ورقاب آبائنا وأمهاتنا والمسلمين من النار يا رب العالمين. Imagine that while your brain might be, I will be one of them tonight. Allah will free me from the hellfire. رسول الله said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, عتقاء من النار في كل ليلة. سبحان الله. Imagine that. Also, الصيام مادة الفرح. When you fast, you have to smile. Give the smile. Because some people, when Ramadan comes, Ramadan again. they don't like to fast. No, when Ramadan comes, you have to give that big smile. Why? Rasulullah said, لِلصَّائِمِ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ فَرْحَتَانِ Those who are fasting, they will be happy twice. Once when they break their fast in the end of the day, alhamdulillah, I'll make one day. And once you go to Allah Azza wa Jal, Allahu Akbar. Allah is hiding the reward of fasting from us. He showed you all good deeds you are doing. Hasana will be multiplied to 10 to 700 to more. Wallahu yudha'ifu liman yasha. But illa as-sawm, except fasting. فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. Means what? He hide the reward, Allah Almighty, the reward of fasting from you. In the day of judgment, you're going to see mountains of hasanat. Ya Rab, I did not do that. No, you did. This is your fasting. Your fasting. Ya Rabbi, the hadith will like, hey, if you fast one day, nafilah, not Ramadan, nafilah, huh? Subhanallah, fi sabilillah, just one day, not Ramadan, this is voluntarily siyam. Allah will take you away, distance from the hellfire, 70 years, 70 kharif, let bil khandaq. 70 years away distance from the fire because you fast one day voluntarily fi sabilillah. Is that enough? No, it's not enough. Because I read one hadith, he said, people, they will be 500 years distance from the hellfire and they will feel its smoke and heat. Wal'azu billah. For like 70 years is not enough, you have to fast more. Subhanallah. And the Jannah also same thing. Sitting 500 years distance, you can smell its fragrance. MashaAllah. Jannah. What about you are inside that? See how Allah loves you, preparing Jannah for you, giving you the ways also to go to Jannah. InshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. Also, Al-I'tikaf. Allah said in the Quran, we learn in Ramadan Al-I'tikaf. Al-I'tikaf, you do it in the last 10 days of Ramadan, but also during the year, you can do it anytime. Do you know Allah with the intention of Al-I'tikaf when you come for Salah? You come for Salah for maybe 30 minutes, you're going to stay in the Masjid during the Salah time. But in your mind, I'm going and I'm going to make I'tikaf in the Masjid. I'm going to cut myself out from the dunya. I'm not in dunya anymore. I'm going to the Masjid. And Allah said, وَأَنْتُمْ عَاكِفُونَ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. الْاعْتِكَافِ in the Masjid, not inside the house. In the Masjid. Also, التعلق بالقرآن الكريم وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرٍ. Brothers and sisters, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when Ramadan comes, Allah is calling you. What Allah is saying? يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ أَقْبِلْ وَيَا بَاغِيَ الشَّرِّ أَدْبِرْ. Hey, what's the meaning? Allah is calling you, يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ. Those who are willing to do good deeds, come, this is your time now. This is your season now. Come, the doors are open for you. Come, man, this is your time. وَيَا بَاغِيَ الشَّرِّ. Those who are seeking evil, their nafs and their shayateen and they are bad, go away. This is not your time now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Also, Ramadan did not forget sisters from al-qiyam, from al-siyam, from al-zikr, wajibat al-islam, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, sisters, al-nisa'u shaqa'iqu al-rijal. Women, they are half of men in everything. Whatever the man is doing, ibadat, sister, you have to do like him and more too. Because I remember when I was imam in Arlington, Texas, 2002, I was in my office and somebody called me. Sheikh Jum'a, the lady, she was talking, making conversation, asking questions. She said, Sheikh Jum'a, I am not praying. Alhamdulillah, my husband praying for me. I said, what? Wallah, your husband, he loves you so much, sister, I told her that. She said, how? She said, he wants you to go to Jahannam direct. She said, yes, he loves you so much. Who told you that? مَنْ عَامِلَ مِنْكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى. Allah said, male and female. When you come to that, worshiping Allah Azza wa Jal, we are equal, men and women. We are equal. She's making hajj, he's making hajj. You see, Salimat Qiyam, your husband making Qiyam. You're sharing everything in ibadah. Don't tell me your husband is going to make a prayer for you or fast for you. No, no, no. Do it for yourself, sister. Yes, he will not be asking about you. He will not be asking about him. كل امرئ بما كسب رهين. You're gonna carry your burden above your shoulder. Nobody will be asking about anybody. Yes, but that's why Allah will not ask you about say Jum'a. He will not ask you Jum'a about you. Allah will ask you Jum'a about say Jum'a. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that sister, you are responsible too. Also, in Ramadan, try to soften your heart, dear brother and sisters, especially when you listen to the Quran, and take advantage of this month. Take advantage of this time. In Ramadan, learn to be nice, kind, gentle, pardon people, forgive them, be generous. Also, tabattah ila Allah, make dua as much as you can. as much as you can, because آية الدعاء comes after آيات الصيام من سورة البقرة. وإذا سألك عبادي عني the end of the page. فإني قري أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. That's why it's very important also another في خيرية هذه الأمة. The Ummah of Muhammad, the best nation. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. Who said Allah? You are the best nation, يا أمة of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Look, when we come to the masjid, when we stand for Allah, for His deen, ولا ينصرن الله من ينصره. Allah سبحانه وتعالى will support the one who is supporting His deen. Allah is not weak to support him, to support the deen of Allah. If you support the deen of Allah, will support you. Allah will help you. Allah will be with you. And when you see Muslims like you are coming together, helping each other, this is the khayriya of this ummah. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل من آدم خطاء وخير خطيئة توبوا إلى الله استغفروا. اللهم يا رب الحمد لله رب العالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وللمؤمنين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Dear respected brother, dear sisters, I'm asking Allah يا رب to make us steadfast in our deen, our iman, يا رب, in our طاعة. الحمد لله, we still in the beginning of the month of Ramadan, this fifth. And subhanAllah, this year is very different for me. Even our masjid Reseda, mashallah, too many people, they are attending Salat al-Fajr, like three lines today. I was very surprised in Salat al-Fajr, the big masjid, mashallah. And Salat al-Tarawih, the masjid is full. I'm sure your masjid too here. فالحمدلله, we see صحوة الإسلام والمسلمين, they are coming back to Allah. And not just the Muslims, those who are converting, they revert. I just came from Umrah with 200 people. عمرة العالم, the world of Umrah, just came before 2 months from, I was leading this Umrah in Saudi Arabia this year. MashaAllah, 200 people from all over the world, they just came to Islam. Yes. And when you see this, and you see these people tearing, and they are coming to Allah Azza wa Jal, you say, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, we are Muslims. Alhamdulillah, because we are the Muslimin. That's why we have to show Allah our goodness as Muslims now. يا ربنا تقبل منا صيام رمضان وأعنا فيه على الصيام والقيام. يا رب اشف من كان منا مريضا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين وتب علينا يا رب العالمين واهدنا إلى صراطك المستقيم ولا تمتنا إلا وأنت راض عنا يا رب العالمين. يا ربنا يسر أمورنا يمن كتابنا واحفظنا جميعا وإياكم من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعلى أيماننا واجعلنا لك يا ربنا من الشاكرين. عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وأتموا الصلاة.